Hi guys, and welcome to another video. In the last episode, we were here, and I was just looking up here. Where'd it go? Kitty! How you doing? In the last episode, we were doing some stuff with our AE network. I explained 101 things about logistics pipes. I hope you guys followed that pretty well. Or, you know, not. Don't matter. But either way, we worked on some stuff. We got some stuff done. And in this episode, we're going to do some more stuff. Believe it or not, we might actually get something done. Okay, these footsteps are freaking me out. But yeah, in the last episode, we did some stuff with AE. Now, I do want to do some more things with logistics pipes. I actually want to do some interesting things that you can't do with AE, and I thought I would show them to you. People are Snapchatting me in the middle of my video, and I hope you couldn't hear that, but that's unprofessional. Either way, we're going to go ahead and get started with this. I'm going to go ahead and clear that out. We need to make a couple patterns, so of course, let's take off area mode, and let's go ahead and which one of these? Right, we're actually going to move all of them, so we're going to go ahead and punch, punch. Punch. Very good. And we should be able to move them. We're going to put this one. Actually, we're going to put him right here. Crafting monitor. Pattern encoder. And partition editor. And that should be good. We should be okay. Just like that. So we're going to go and put this down. And go like that. And we're going to go ahead and search logistics. Or actually, we could do at logistics. Right, so we've got logistics pipes up in our thing here. So what we want to do is we want to make a logistics crafting pipe pattern. Very good, encode. And we also want to make a satellite logistics pipe pattern. And I'll explain what each of these do here in a minute. Let's go ahead and shift-click these guys into here. And let's go ahead and make a few. Now let's look up potion. That didn't help. Let's see, can we go in here and find potions? Item subsets. Blocks. No, we don't. Oh, god damn it. This thing's so hard to use, because if you go over too far... Let's see, vanilla. Vanilla, items, potions. Is that what we want? Yes. Right, so we want to make potions. Now, in order to make potions, like we got water bottles... these can be made with our mods automatically, but we want to make some of these basic potions to start off with. Okay, we're going to make the awkward potion. So we're going to be looking at these recipes quite a bit. So first off, we need actually a brewing stand, which would have been great if I had thought about that. Let's go ahead and re-enable all of these, and let's search for... Oops. Brewing stand. Very good. Brewing stand, one blaze rod, three cobblestone, very simple recipe. Let's go ahead and encode that. Very good. Let's throw this in here. Now we got a brewing stand. Now let's go ahead and look. Blaze. Of course I don't have any blaze rods, but we do have these safari nets, which is actually very useful because all I need to do really is come up here, throw the blaze into this spawner, and get it ready to auto-spawn. So let's go ahead and throw the villagers out of here. Now, it would be best to do this in a closed environment. Let me grab some glass, and let me go ahead and make some... Whoops. Make some walls out of this glass, and I will be right back. Alright, guys. So, I went ahead and I set up a giant glass cage, and I actually moved this spawner down a little bit, and I filled in... what was down below. So I have a blaze spawner here. Now the only thing I need to configure on this is I need to tell this to fill. Basically what I'm going to do is I'm going to set this before I do anything else. I'm going to set this to mob essence. Should be right around here somewhere. There we go, essence. And we're going to set two buckets on this. Okay, and that should pull from that tank over there, and eventually we should get in here. This to be filled with exactly two buckets. So it's filled with a one and a quarter. There we go, two buckets exactly. So when we turn this on, we're going to start spawning blazes. Blazes? Man, that thing scared me. Right, so let's go ahead and try this out, and we'll see how this goes. Now, we're basically going to punch him with our fists so we get the full luck 4 or whatever enchant doohickey that we have on this. And we should see. Here we go. Let's punch him. Punch him to death. Should be pretty good. Sorry if it's loud. I didn't even think that it was going to be loud. Oh, goodness. You guys are mean. Hang on. Hold up. I didn't realize that was going to do so much damage to me. Hopefully they can't find their way out of there. And I did break a piece of glass here, didn't I? Oh, man. I should have eaten before I started that. Yeah. That could end disastrously. I think if I'm to leave this area and come back, they would despawn. Let's go ahead and... Oh, God. Oh, don't burn anything down. Please. Please, no. Oh, God. I'm leaving. I'm leaving. My goodness. Okay, hopefully they despawn. I'm going to head back there here in just a second. After my health regenerates. Wow, I thought my armor was better than that. I have the sturdy enchant on every one, and I can sit in lava for a little bit, but man, blazer, no joke. I might have to rethink that strategy. I might have to grab some of these grinders or what? I guess that's not a grinder. But yeah, we'll see how that goes once my health goes back up. It'd be nice to have a regen potion, actually, for this, and then I wouldn't have to worry too much about it. Oh, man, to think I was going to fight the Wither. Whoops. Let's not consider that for a little bit longer. Let's go ahead and head back. Hopefully they've despawned. Okay, they have. Good. Oh, man, that could have ended really badly. Let's make sure there's no fire around. All right. We're going to try that again. This time we're only going to spawn a couple, and then we're going to turn it off. So as soon as this work idle or whatever gets down, and the work goes all the way up, we're going to go ahead and turn it off. Right? And done. And done. Okay. Very good. We got one. Bam. Right? Okay. 14 blaze rods. Not bad. So we'll do the same thing. So we'll do this just for a little bit. I shouldn't need too many blaze rods because I'm only making the potion stands or whatever for now. So as soon as... All right. Yep. Come here. Come here. Oops. Very good. It's not too bad. Let's see. We got 18 now. That should be good. I'm going to do one more, and then we will call this a day. So, pretty simple stuff. Not too difficult to do. And yeah, I definitely am going to need to see if I can figure out how to make this armor better. I thought it was a lot better than it is. There we go, 24. That'll be plenty. So let's go ahead and throw these into our system here. And let's get started on some auto crafting. Now, I do need to do some things really quick, like right now in person. So I'll be right back. And yeah. All right, guys, we are back, and I just slapped, and we are going to go ahead and work on... What are we working on? I feel really dumb right now. What was... I don't even know what I was going to say. Right, we're going to work on this automated... What are they? Hang on, let me just look. What did I just make? Right, the brewing stands. So, automated brewing stands. Brewing stands. Actually, you know what? Let's search... awkward potion. Now, what is this? Yeah, it's potion. Potion! Look how many potions there are. Awkward potion, thick potion, mundane potion, blah, 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 blah. So, I do want to make, eventually, every single kind of potion that there is, but since I'm not quite prepared to do that, we're not going to be doing that today. Now, the first thing that we're going to need in order to make potions is we're going to need... water bottles. So how are we going to get water bottles? Well, the easiest way, to be honest, let's see, is, well, if I could get to it, smeltery, no, don't be silly. Let's see, recipe for water bottle. Oh, I'm actually quite confused. It's not using the magma crucible. I'm surprised it doesn't show the recipe. Let's head back to spawn really quick. I forget the name of the machine, so I'm just going to have to look. It is called the Liquid Transposer. That's what we need. So let's go back to our base and make a Liquid Transposer. Liquid Transposer. Very good. We're going to make one of them. That should be fine. And we're also going to make an Aqueous Accumulator, which we do not have a recipe for. So let's go ahead and make that. Aqueous Accumulator. Very good. And code. Bam. Very nice. Now we can craft one of these guys. Hopefully. Gonna work? Yeah. All right. So we got an Aqueous Accumulator. We've got a... Dang it. What was it called? Sorry, guys. I'm really bad. My memory just sometimes doesn't. Liquid Transposer. Duh. I knew that. Transposer. Liquid Transposer. Very good. And we're also going to need some water buckets, but we won't worry about that. And actually, I think someone... Maybe not. I thought someone gave me a thing that gives you water, but either way, we've got this now. So what we're going to do is we are going to... or set it up. Where do we want this, actually? I don't even know. We're going to go ahead and put it right here. Doesn't matter. I'm doing it. So first thing, we're going to put down the Aqueous Accumulator. Let's go ahead. Excuse me. Make sure area mode is off. Next thing we're going to do is go ahead and disable all the outputs and disable redstone control. I always do that. It's just out of habit. It's a good thing to get into. All right, and then up here, we're going to put our liquid transposer. We're going to do the same thing. We're going to switch it. You know what? Let's get a bottle. Bottle one. Thank you. Made three. That's fine. Doesn't matter. We put the bottle in here. And this fills with water, so we want the bottom to be that. Very good. And we actually also want... what side? Let's do the right-hand side. We'll make the right-hand side also an input. So these are both going to input different things. Now, we do need to provide it power, but we'll worry about that in a second. Now I'm kind of thinking we should move it over here. Yeah, we'll leave it here. It's fine. Let's move it. Nah, it's not. Okay, right. So we've got our Aqueous Accumulator. Now, if we let this go, I think it's actually going to have water in here. Yeah, it's got water in here already, but we're going to go ahead and place down a water bucket. We're going to go grab a little bit more water, place down another water bucket, and then we should be good. Right? Very good. Now we're filling it with water. Very nice. And once it gets to... Oh, we need to switch this to the other way. No, do we? Oh, it needs power. I'm dumb. Right. Disable redstone control. All the other outputs are gone. We're also going to suck... actually, you know what? Let's switch that to red and make that one blue. So let's go ahead and see. Do I have an export? Nope, I don't. Export bus. We're going to go ahead and make one of these guys. So let's go ahead and make ME basic export bus in code. We also need an import bus. Now, I think I actually already have one. It's a basic import bus, so that's going to be fine. Right? Oh, you know what? No, we don't want this. What do we want? That's fine. That's fine. We're going to go ahead and put this pattern in here. We don't need the import bus, though. Oh, yeah, we do. We do need the import bus. Okay. Don't be dumb, Jassassin. We need a cable. 1ME cable from Applied Energistics. Very good. Right. We're going to put the cable here. We're also going to need an interface, right? An ME interface. And we're out of materials. Oh, no, we're not. Okay, good. We're going to put the interface on the top. And we might need one more cable. That would have been a wise thing to get. Let's go ahead and put that right. Nope. Well, that works too, I guess. All right, so we've got this. Now, the thing that we're going to need to do is we're going to need to say pattern. Oh, you know what? We already have one. We're going to go in here. We're going to say clear. If you give this thing one, two, oops. If you give this thing three glass bottles, you should get... Actually, you know what? I'm just going to make it one for one. So let's go ahead and see. Did this thing bottle water? Did it not pull out of here? Let's see. Oh, duh, because it never made it. I still need power. So let's go ahead and get power running to this. Let's go straight this way with it and then go straight that way. Yeah, that'll be fine. So let's go like this. Oop. Pardon me. Sand. Oh, you're in the way. We'll fix you in a second. All right, and then we're going to go straight this way. Right, now we need energy conduit. Okay, I hope I have enough. This could be an issue. We're going to run you straight like that. Let's get some stone transport pipe. One, two. I think that's all I need. Two, hopefully. Right, just like that. One, two, three. And then we'll run the conduit just like this. Oh yeah, I should have enough. Right, we'll break this, place one there, up one, and then we will move this to the other side. Oh, come on. All right, so first off, let's go ahead and right-click this guy, shift-click, and double-click. Very good. Place this over here, and then our cable, and then our other cable. Can go right there. That should be fine. Okay. Then the only thing we need to do is just connect that, and that should get power. And it did. And it's going to fill that water bottle. And then we'll get a water bottle in our system. Very good. Now, if we grab the water bottle and we add it to this pattern, and we click encode, then we can say, if you want a water bottle, this thing will make you a water bottle. Right? So all I need to do is go in here and say water bottle. Right? And I'm actually going to craft 10 of these, just so we can see it working. So I crafted 10. Now this thing should have... Ooh. I didn't ask for 27. I asked for 10. I may have broken that pattern, to be honest. Let's go ahead and craft one water bottle with three glass bottles. Right. That's why that broke. So let's actually go ahead and say 2-1 encode. One water bottle with one glass bottle. Very good. That's much better. That's much more like what we were trying to do. So let's go ahead and clear out this recipe and put the pattern back over here. Right. That's going to be a lot better. So this will make our water bottles. So that is very nice to have. Now this thing can actually also fill water, can fill buckets. So I think I'm actually going to create a pattern really quick that'll do that. So if you put a bucket, you will get... a water bucket. So let's head over here and grab some water. This is going to be really useful for caving. If I run out and I forget a water bucket, I can make it get me one. So that's really nice. So I'm going to say water bucket encode. Very good. And same thing, I'm just going to put this pattern in here. Now let's go ahead and pull out. Okay, it's already done. Let's go ahead and request a water bucket. Well, let's see. The best way to do this, I'm going to dump my water in here. So I have an empty bucket in the system. Now if I say bucket, right, you can see I have one bucket and I need one water bucket, so I'm going to request one, and it takes my bucket and it makes a water bucket. Very good. So that's really nice as well. Now this can be used to make all kinds of things, but for now this is what its goal is. This is what its job is. It's going to do its job as I told it. Right. I think that's going to be about it. I'm going to go ahead and finish covering that up. That's very, very wonderful. Trying to think if there's anything else. Okay, I think that's about it for that. So let's go ahead and get rid of everything that we don't need for now. And actually, even we're going to go ahead and put this in there and this in there. Just so we have a cleaner inventory, right? Should be good. Now, what else do we want to get done? Let's go ahead and make... I need a crafting logistics pipe. Now... let's go ahead and look at the potions again, because that's what we were looking at. Potions. Oh, you know what? First off, let's look at the Magnum Torch. This will give us a good goal. Magnum Torch, right? So what I want to do is I want to make this. Now, this requires a Potion of Regeneration 2. Oh, wait. And a Potion of Instant... a Potion of Healing, and this is Instant Health 2. So we need to make regeneration and health potions, and we also need the second step of those. So we basically need, well, let's look. Potion, Actually, wait. We're going to keep looking at this recipe for our potion. So, we're going to start with the regeneration. So, that is a potion of regeneration with glowstone. So, we're going to have to go build a potion of regeneration. That is an awkward potion with a tear. So, and an awkward potion is a water bottle with nether wart. So, we basically need 6 brewing stands. Right. So, let's go ahead and craft 6. It should be really easy to have. And let's go ahead and put them somewhere. Let's put them right up against this back piece right here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Very good. Now, if you guys don't know how these work, you can actually automate these in vanilla using hoppers and all kinds of timing mechanisms and nonsense like that. While that is kind of cool, it's not nearly as cool as what you can do with logistics pipes. So let's go ahead and make 3 crafting logistics pipes. Or not 3, 6. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Right? And let's also make 6 satellite pipes. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Begin. 4 and 6. Very good. Now, what these will do, I'm probably... Which one goes where? I'm going to go ahead. Let's first off get all the sand out from underneath here. Let's go ahead and fix that. I think I'll connect it here. Maybe we'll connect it at this end. Oh, did I miss one? I did. Whoops. Yeah, we'll connect it there. So we're going to put our crafting logistics pipes down below each one here. And our satellite logistics pipes up on top. All right, and then we're going to get some stone. Oops, what am I doing? I was going to search for it in NEI. Stone transport pipes. Right, let's go ahead and grab some of these. We're also going to grab a couple sandstone ones. Should be good. We're also going to grab a basic logistics pipe or 2 or 27. That's fine. That'll work. And you know what? We'll branch off right here. So we're going to put our logistics pipe there. We're going to put our stone transport pipes right here. Okay. We're going to put one more right there and there. And we're going to put our sandstone one there. Now, if you don't know, sandstone pipes prevent them from connecting to inventories. Like, if I were to put a stone one here, you see it connects to the brewing stand, and that would mess up our system. So I have to put a sandstone one there if I want it to be set up that way. Okay. So the next thing that I'm going to do is go ahead and put some of the sand back. I think that'll work, right? So this whole system is connected. Now I need to configure each one. Now I probably should have left that sand out. I don't think I'm going to be able to access these. So let's actually remove the sand that I just put back because I'm a wise one. Right. And you know what? Let's sleep because... Oh, is TFC back on? No, he isn't. Okay, good. Let's sleep and We'll get this going. I just don't want a creeper to sneak up on me or anything like that. Right. So, let's go ahead and get this going. So, we're going to need all of the resources for each of these potions. Okay. So, we're going to need glowstone for both of them. And we're also going to need a tear or a gas tear. You know, I'm not actually sure. How do you make a tear? Gas tear comes from those... tier, I'm not actually sure. If you guys know how to make tiers, and if they're pretty easy to make, I might switch to these. But for now, we're going to have to use gas tiers. Ooh, and we only have 3, so this could be a problem. But we won't worry about it for now. We need tiers. We also need glowstone. Whoops. And we need this stuff, nether wart. We need a glass bottle. Right? And hope that's it. Oh no, we don't need a glass bottle. We need a water bottle. Water bottle. Very good. All right, and that should be good. So magnum torch. Let's see. Let's see if I got that right. So tier and an awkward potion. Right. So the way that we're going to do this is we're going to go ahead and right click on... Well, let's first open up the inventory of the brewing stand. Now, in the top is where you put the material that you're brewing, right? So, for example, nether wart goes in the top. And then our glass bottles go in the bottom three slots. So what we're going to do is we're going to right-click on this guy with our wrench. And we're going to say three glass bottles, right? And netherwort in the satellite. Now, if you remember, this is a satellite logistics pipe, and this is a crafting logistics pipe. Now, the way this works is we come up here, and we're going to set this to ID 6, apparently. Oh, other people are probably using them. This one's going to be 7. This one's going to be 8. This one's going to be 9. This one's going to be 10. And this one's going to be 11, right? So 6 through 11. So this one's going to start at 6. Very good. Oh, and it actually only sees the one in the network. So 6, 7, 6, 7, 8, 6, 7, 8, 9, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Very good. Right? So this one's 11, and that one down there is 11. Perfect. So basically, what we're saying is put three water bottles in the bottom and then send the netherwort up to the top one, and that will insert it in at the top. So we're going to do the same thing for this. First off, we need to craft awkward potions. Now, if this system is set up correctly, it will do it, but I will need to make an awkward potion first. So let's go ahead and do this, and it should make it. I'm not actually sure. We'll see how this works. This could be interesting to see. It's going to make an awkward potion, and then what's it going to do with it? Is it going to leave it there? Awkward potion. Very good. It left it there. Hopefully that's not what it does all the time. But right, I need to tell this crafting logistics pipe that what it is making is three awkward potions. Right? Very good. So all I do is set it that way, and it should be good, right? So we're going to go in here, and we're going to craft awkward potions. You can see it makes, I have the recipe here. So we're going to go ahead and request it. It should send the bottles in there. You can see them landed there, and the netherwort got placed. So we're going to wait for this to brew, and hopefully this system is going to extract the bottles out of it when it's finished. Now, if it doesn't do that, I might need to do, I don't actually know. I'm not actually sure what I'm going to do if that doesn't work. Oh, and there it goes. And you can see it went ahead and pulled those out, and it went ahead and dropped them back into our system. So if I look for awkward potion, I have one. Oh, there we go. And I have one, two. What the heck? Where did they go? That was weird. I've never seen that happen before. That was very strange. Let's see if maybe I accidentally connected something. That is very strange. They should have ended up in our AE system. I might need to tweak that a bit, but we'll see. So we now have awkward potions. So basically what we're going to do here is very similar. I'm going to say 1, 2, 3 awkward potions plus a ghast tier in satellite pipe number 7. We'll do whatever this is. So we're going to go ahead and throw all three in here with the ghast tier. And this should craft three of the next level potion, right? So you get the point. It's pretty self-explanatory at this point. So I'm going to go ahead and set up the rest of these, and I will be back when I'm finished. All right, guys. So the next one that I need to make is the potion of healing, right? So to make this, I need an awkward potion and a glistening melon. Glistening melon is made with a melon and a gold nugget, which is really simple. So let's go ahead and make a pattern for that really quick. So we're going to go ahead and click this guy, click that guy, click that guy, click that guy, click that, and do this, and encode, and right? So glistening melon. Now I need to request glistening melon. One of them. Begin. And done. Very good. So what I've got here, let's go ahead and just take a look. We've got our awkward potion that brews in this one. I meant to click here. So that makes our awkward potion. This one makes our potion of regeneration. This one makes regeneration 2. Now this one is going to make healing potions. So we're going to put the glistening melon there. And then we're going to go ahead and craft these. So you know what? Let's request more awkward potions. We're going to request 2, 3 of these. Right, that should do it. Bam, bam, bam. And let's see. Three water bottles makes three awkward potions. Yeah, I just want to make sure I have that right. Now, let's see where the bottles actually go, because they didn't end up in my AE system last time, and I was really confused by that. They may have ended up in this ender chest or something. Oh, no. They all went in. Let's go see. Awkward potion. Oh, they did. Okay, very good. Let's go ahead and... So, we've got our awkward potions. So, we're going to go ahead and right-click on this guy. Oh, no, this guy, rather. So, 1, 2, and 3 with our glistening melon. And then that will give us 3 of our healing potions. And then we need one more piece of glowstone. Right? One piece of glowstone. Very good. And that will make us our second level. Now, I realize I made an extra brewing stand. So, maybe we will make a speed potion or something like that. Let's see. Are you done yet? Oh, yeah, you are. Okay, potion of healing. 1, 2, and 3. So the next one is going... Well, this one first is going to output 3 potions of healing. Right, and then this next one here is going to take in 1, 2, 3 potions of healing. And you're going to put glowstone on it. And you're going to output the next level. So let's go ahead and put these guys in here. 1, 2, 3, and the glowstone. And that will make our second level. Sorry for... The repetitiveness of this kind of comes with the territory, I guess. Hopefully you guys don't mind too much. I'm pretty excited about making all of this. Automated potion crafting is OP. In before Hypno comments, automated potion crafting is OP. Right. All I need to do is say this one gives you 3 of the level 2. Right. And that's all we should need. So we have these potions in here. We're going to go ahead and put everything back that I don't need right now. And we're going to start making the patterns for this guy. So let's go ahead and clear that out. We're going to need, first off, to make chandeliers, which are really easy. Okay, cool. So shift-click, encode, done. The other thing we might need is torches. We're going to make them with coal because I have more coal than charcoal. The next thing that we're going to need is just this. So we should have everything required to make a magnum torch at this point. So let's go ahead and magnum torch. Now let's go ahead. Whoops. I think we're going to go a little bit crazy and we're going to request 20 of these. Now let's see how our logistics system handles the potions. Because I am quite interested to see. Actually, you know what? Options, video settings, particles, all. Okay, good. And it's missing something. Oh, it's missing gold. Of course it's missing gold. Why wouldn't it be missing gold? Gold. Yeah, very good. Let's go ahead. I'm going to go ahead and do what I did before. Man, and head over to spawn and grind up some gold, all right? So I will be back when I have some gold. Actually, you know what? Gold or berries. Gold. Oh, nope. Not enough of them. Okay. Yep, I'm going to go ahead and head to spawn and smelt up some gold. Alright, guys. So I'm over here, and I'm melting up some gold. But I was messing around with NEI, and I was just looking at a few things, and I found an item called an auto disenchanter. And I'm quite interested to see what it does, because I might have a really interesting use for it. So let's go back to the base, and let's see if we can make one of these. So first off, let's just go ahead and... clear that out. Let's get its pattern and encode it and just see if we can make it off the bat. So, auto disenchanter from Mine Factory Reloaded. And that's gonna be a no. It's probably missing the gold that I'm smelting right now. Dang it. Dang it. Dang it. Okay. Oh, you know what? Pattern. I have a nether brick pattern. that I don't have in here. So it'll make that nether brick, but it's still gonna need the gold. So we're gonna be short on the gold for this project. Darn it, what is auto brewer?
Whoa!
Oh my goodness. There's an automatic brewing stand? Ooh, I might need to make one of these too. Auto anvil, meh. Let's see, auto spawner, auto jukebox, auto enchanter. Automated steam trap. Yeah, I think I want to make one of these. So let's go ahead. I'm really curious what both of these do, because these could be way better than what I've got set up here. So we've got a pattern for that as well. So let's go ahead and get one of the auto brewers. Otto Brewer. Otto Brewer? There we go. Get one of those requested up as well. Now, all of these things require gold. Oh, and this one requires... Interesting, a repeater. Let's go ahead and get repeater pattern. Why not? And code. And in fact, let's get... You know what? I think I already have redstone torch patterns and stuff, so that's fine. Let's see if it made it, actually. Okay, yeah, it looks like it made the repeaters that it needed. Interesting. Right, let's head back to spawn. And let's see how we're doing on our gold. I hope I have enough. I should only need, like, 20. So let's grab what's here, and then I'll grab whatever's left later. If I remember. Which I probably won't. Let's be honest, I probably won't remember. But that's fine. For now, this should be good. Let's go back to the base. Go ahead and input all our gold and get everything crafted up. Okay, so let's go ahead and watch the brewing stands populate. You only got a single one. No, don't brew yet. Oh, it's terrible. You're supposed to wait. That's no good. That's gonna break our whole system. You gotta wait. Oh, there we go. Very good. Alright, well... As long as we always do it in multiples of three, it should be fine, but it's just because I had that one extra awkward potion in the system. Interesting. Yeah, so those are going to go out and go into there, and then they're going to go out and flow out, and we're going to have that extra awkward potion ruining everything. Let's go ahead and grab this out. Take one. Oops, did I not take it? Where did it go? Dang it, I think... Okay, let's go ahead and drink it. There. Now that won't be... Because that's all that would screw up our system, is the uneven number of items. Okay, those are going to go back in and pop back out. I think. I hope. Maybe not. Uh-oh. Magnum torch. We got three of them. Oh, we're probably out of gold again. Are we? Instant health too. Now we're out of raw plastic. Instant health too. It's doing like one at a time. That's really weird. I'm not sure where they're going. Like, I feel like... Are you making that? I'm so confused. Where? Instant health. I have two of them in there. Instant health too. Odd. Very odd. Let's see if, my remote orderer sees it. Let's see. Oh yeah, we have three. Oh, regeneration two. One of the instant health potions disappeared. Where could it have gone? I do not know. I do not know. What? Game, you're drunk. Where did you put my instant health? I need that. God damn it. If I could request it. Let's go ahead and request one instant health two potion. Just because it's going to make them anyway. What is going on? My brain broke. It's all completely broken. We're missing one of those. Instant health two. Instant health two. What? You're not in here, are you? Where? What? Game, why? What are you doing to me? Yeah, I'm not actually sure what's going on here. I have a feeling... Nope, not singing. Let's go to spawn really quick. I've got a quick fix for this. Not the best fix, I'll be honest. But a quick one. We're gonna go ahead and grab this guy here. And we're going to force wrench our... Logistics power junction. Bam! And place it back. That should fix everything, so we head back. Oops. Pressing the wrong buttons again. Very good. Hopefully that'll clear any crafting out, maybe? Possibly? Instant health, too. What? I'm so confused. My brain is just... I don't understand. Oh, you know, maybe it was expecting that awkward potion. Let's go ahead and craft one awkward potion. Let's go ahead and craft instant health one. I don't know. Everything is broken. I don't understand. Yeah, my brain hurts a lot, guys. Let's go and wait for this to finish crafting and see what happens. There's got to be something weird going on here. I mean, right? What? I bet you. Let's go in here. I bet you they're in these chests. Yep. Why are they going back to spawn? You are drunk. Oh, because it sees it as the default route. That's a problem. That's a major issue. Let's go ahead and grab this as well. Okay. Okay, so it was waiting for those because it knew that they were in the system, but it expected them to show up in AE, and they didn't. So that's an issue. But it's not the biggest issue we could have. So what I can do to fix that is set the default route over here, and then I think this has a configuration for... Oh, God. Oh, God, why are you requesting all these things? I think this has... Yeah. The resistance on this, I do believe you can set it to basically make the default routes separate on each side of that. But we'll see. Hopefully that solved our issue. Now let's go ahead and look in here. Let's go ahead and cancel the instant health craft. Cancel. Okay. Instant health 2 we're missing. Let's go ahead and cancel you as well. And then we're going to go ahead and make some raw plastic. Rubber bars. We're going to take some of these. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Very good. We're actually going to head to spawn. Keep pressing the wrong number. Now I've got the numbers backwards in my head again. Right, so we're going to go ahead and make some raw plastic. We actually need quite a bit of it, so might as well start off just like this. But yeah, wow. My brain is really just broken. I'm almost positive that that's a default route issue. So I'm going to have to think up a way to fix that, like the best way to fix that. In the meantime, I can put... this is a provider, isn't it? Provider module, yep. I don't know what's going on. Oh, you know what? It's because these... No? Nope. Don't know why it is. I'm going back to my base because my brain is broken. All right, so... Yeah, we still need the raw plastic. Let's go get some raw plastic. We only need a couple, so should be all right. To just grab a couple out of here, maybe. Get a couple out of there and head back. Yep, and that should get our stuff made. Right, let's go ahead and make auto brewer, yep, and auto disenchanter. I'm really curious to know how these things both work. So we're going to put them both down. The auto disenchanter is the one that I'm most curious about. So let's go ahead and take, what is it? Gold. I have a bunch of enchanted gold armor that I've picked up off of zombies and stuff. So let's go ahead and grab some of this stuff and see exactly what we can do with it. Yeah, that should be good. Let's see. And I think we need books. So it looked like that we needed books. Let's go ahead and make a stack of books if we can. 4, 8, 12. Very good. That'll be good for now. It needs power, so this wasn't the best place to put it. Let's go ahead and place it right here for now. So I got power. Very good. We put the armor in there. Okay, and it looks like we put the books... Perhaps not. Maybe there? Ah. So we can do one at a time, and wow, that's kind of slow. So let's see what it does. It's probably going to put the armor down here and the book down there. That's what I'm guessing. And then we could probably pipe it out. Now, can we search? It's very interesting. So, Yeah, let's wait for this to go and we'll see exactly what it does. Whoop, we're losing a lot of power. We're out of power. Ran out of power. Very good. Get working. And okay, cool. So it put our projectile protection on a book and it disenchanted the armor. It looks like it actually damaged it quite a bit. But that's fine. That doesn't really matter. Let's grab... Let's see if we can shift-click the armor. Okay, so the armor automatically drops down. That's very good to know. Okay, and the books, if we were to throw an enchanted book, automatically drops down as well. Very good. Oh man, that's exciting. So let's go ahead and take this chest plate, since it's fully healed, and we'll see what the damage dealt to it actually is. But that is a very, very cool mechanic to have. Now let's see, the next one is the auto brewer, which I'm assuming also needs power, so we're going to place it right here. Whoa. My brain is broken. So I'm going to just pretend that I never placed this. I might look at it later, but it's not for this video. Oh man, this auto disenchanter is really cool though. Let's go and wait for this and see if it damages this chest plate. Come on, come on, come on. You can do it. And it does a tiny bit of damage. 101 of 112. Okay, so it probably damages certain things different amounts. Haste 1, projectile protection. Very cool. I'm going to go ahead and break this for now because we don't actually need it yet. But that's something that we will probably end up using sometime in the near future. So that's pretty exciting. Let's go ahead and put all this stuff back in here. Get everything sorted in my inventory. Now, I don't think... Wow, what the heck? Oh, it's out of fuel there. Auto... Wait, what is it? Magnum torch? Now, if you guys don't know, these magnum torches prevent mobs spawning within a certain radius of them. Or hostile mobs spawning, that is. So I'm actually going to go ahead and break that guy and place one right here. Bam! So now mobs can't spawn within a certain distance of this torch. I'm also going to put one like out here somewhere on this side. And one over here somewhere. And I might figure out the radiuses of these sometime, but not right now. That should be good for now to keep this area relatively safe from mobs spawning. But yeah, I think that's going to be about it for now. Let's go ahead and try to craft one more magnum torch and just see exactly what happens here with all these potions that craft. Because it is so confusing. Oh, and I don't even think potions are crafting. What is going on here? Oh, we're going to go ahead and clear out the books. We don't need... And it is missing the instant health. It should know how to craft those, though. I am so confused about this whole thing. I'm going to have to figure out what's going on here. Let's see if we have... No, we don't... Oh, yeah, we do have. We have 3 regeneration potions. 1, 2, 3. We also have 2 instant health potions. 2. Right? So strange. I'm not sure why it doesn't end up in AE. Let's go ahead and throw these in here. Let's see. Did that do it? No, it's still waiting for the instant health. Very strange. I don't understand it. I'm going to do some research off camera on that, but I do want to thank you guys for watching this video. If you enjoyed the episode, go ahead and leave a rating, and until next time, I will see you guys later.